Reward without work. Part 2. Son husband's wifey strikes back. Tonight, the supercharger heaven takes a damn good look at the overprotection and added excuses given to the son husbands. It's so bad one case ended in murder. It's a crying damn shame when they are raised to never have accountability for their actions. And when life holds them accountable and son husband wifey can't come to the rescue. Sit back and watch a fucking train wreck in 1080p 60fps. Watch as the prefrontal cortex shuts completely the fuck down. Nothing will matter to son husband wifey. Not a job, the son husband girlfriend or wife, not even her husband or man, not even family or friends can get through to son husband wifey. When told about the behavior, be ready for maximum hostility, irrational psychotic disorder with a vengeance. Tonight's video clips will fully support these claims. Studies find a lot do this behind closed doors, and it is so very severe to the 10th fucking power. Believe that shit. Now, ladies and gents, black licorice eating motherfuckers, dumbass dudes still trapped in the 90s listening to Brother Lynch like the shit just came out, PPP loan scammers, watch your asses. I give you the champion of Matulu's River, the Grand Inquisitor, the original Chitlin Circuit cartel leader, the Grand Thook of Lentaw, Membente's magic staff, the real brother caught between the moon and the Mile High City, the talented Laquint Dickey.
Duke of Lentois, Prince Mama Walden, motherfucker, that's Blackula. I'm the PPP loan scamming destroyer. I'm the talented Mr. Dickey, y'all. And today's show, conclusion, part two. No more talking about this shit. You know what I'm saying? This is it. I hope everybody had a good weekend. It was Memorial Day weekend. We about to hit this one. Conclusion, baby. How's everybody doing? Yeah. Hell yeah. Yes. It is Wednesday in the Mile High City. And tell you the truth, I was kind of conflicted because I really wanted to talk about Venezuelans. Invasion 2024 part two is coming, and I'm about to go the fuck off on that shit because I am in Colorado. So yeah, we seeing that shit, man. I got motherfuckers on location. We might just go ahead and just do like what Dickie on location. I'll jump in some motherfucking slacks and shit, church shoes, like I'm a real reporter out there. You know what I'm saying? With a 9mm on my shit, though. You know what I mean? Can't do it in Denver, you know what I mean? Because they got carry laws. Remember, I'm an instructor. Well, welcome back, you know what I'm saying, to the broadcast or podcast, whatever the fuck you want to call it. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you want to call it. We're going to go ahead and just hit it right from part one, you know what I'm saying, and just piggyback on the shit, right? I'm sitting here like, should I tell a story first, you know what I mean? Or should I just jump right into this shit and just get after it? You know what I mean? Because if you see the thumbnail and shit, these bitches got motherfucking lightsabers and shit. They ready to go. That's why it's called a son, husband, wife. He strikes back because they ready to fucking go. And these clips tonight is going to show you a whole bunch of irrational shit they've done to get themselves in trouble, get they man, not they man. Look at that. See? I just did that shit. See that shit? I just did that. But to get themselves in trouble or either get their sons in a fucking, like a fucking bind with their girlfriends, wives, whatever, or just in a bind with life, period. Like every damn show, let me tell you a little story first. Let me tell you a story real quick. I got one in me. Let's see, can real quick. And of course, let me hit the cranberry juice with the liquid death. This is cherry. Hope everybody had a good weekend. Check it out. I'm gonna say fourth or fifth grade. There was this motherfucker, and I don't know if this motherfucker's still around or not. But this was this dusty ass fucking kid we grew up with and shit. He had a curl, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how the fuck you dusty as shit, but your curl is lavished in a motherfucker at that age, right? This dirty little motherfucker's name was Isha. And I know damn well Isha stole my bike. You know what I mean? Always been good with the hands, you know what I'm saying? And it came down from wrenching and shit, you know what I mean? So I put together this bike, spray painted this motherfucker yellow, and then just hit it with tiger stripes. I don't know what was up with me and tiger stripes and shit. Like tigers, you know what I mean? Lions and shit. I fucked around and had a rock group back in the day called the Deadly Tigons. I'm being real as fuck with y'all. You know what I mean? It was just something about that shit. You know, Def Leppard, Deadly Tigons. You get the fucking picture. But check it. So I built this bike. Spray paint the shit out of it. You know what I mean? I know it's my bike. This little dirty motherfucker smelling like piss. This motherfucker roll up with my bike and he just spray painted a little bit on it. So I looked at the back of the forks and shit and seen the yellow. So I'm like, yo, man, that's, you know what I mean? That's my bike. You know what I mean? That's my shit. You know, I didn't curse back then, but I was still real young, so I wasn't really fighting yet. This motherfucker went, got his mom, and his mom come out, you know, oh, you know, my baby didn't do shit, basically. You know what I mean? I understand dad wasn't around. You know what I mean? He couldn't come and say shit or tell us shit. This little dirty motherfucker had my bike, and my brothers, you know, brothers, I'm saying with an S because it was, you know, Juan and, you know, my older brother, Alex, they was hyping me up like, you know what I'm saying? It's your bike. You know what I mean? You better get, you know what I mean? Get your bike. You know what I mean? You got to do something to them and shit. You know what I mean? So I let a day go by. So day goes by, fucking weekend goes by. Get to school Monday, and this is still like the beginning of school year, so this is just coming off the summer. I see Isha's ass coming out from John a mess, but we went to school. So I see Isha's ass coming out after school, and yeah, I had to fucking work him, you know what I mean? So I beat him up, you know what I mean? Go back, you know what I'm saying, and tell my mom, like, hey, you know, this boy stole the bike. So that's why I had to fight him. My mom didn't get on me hard, but she sure did tell me, you know what I'm saying, if you got to fight, you got to fight. You know what I mean? Don't let nobody do that shit to you. You know what I mean? I didn't rely on my fucking mom to go up over to Isha and be like, get my baby his bike. None of that shit. She let us handle that, right? As boys. Normal shit, right? Not the stealing. You know what I'm saying? Not the stealing and shit. And damn sure not that motherfucking Jerry curl. His curl was lavish as shit, like ready for the world. And that's real. But that shit wasn't normal for no kids. But anyway, I got my bike. The whole nine, you know what I'm saying? Moms didn't have to go fight for me. You know what I mean? And those are the things right there that you just kind of disregard. But as you get older, now I see guys my age and shit who's been real coddled, you know what I mean, like their whole time. I never had to push, you know what I'm saying? You can see it now. These motherfuckers is grown as shit, you know what I mean? living with fucking chicks and shit, getting them pregnant on purpose for a place to stay because they didn't have to rise to the fucking occasion and just go do, just go work. Go get your fucking bike back. You know what I'm saying? Go work. You know what I mean? Stand up, be a man. And you see their wives or girlfriends or whatever the fuck, you can see mad frustration in their face. Straight up. You know what I'm saying? Like, just not being a man. You gotta be a man. And I harp on this series is because, you know what I'm saying, this is the start of it. You know what I'm saying? Homeboy's mom and shit. Oh, my baby didn't do anything. You know what I'm saying? Bitch, you see that's my fucking bike. You know what I mean? I know that's my bike. I see it on the back of the forks where my yellow paint is. But she's sitting there, excuse me, irrational than a motherfucker, hopping up and down and shit about it. Cool. You know what I'm saying? I had to beat your fucking son. You know what I mean? Oh, well. So, over it, all that shit. Got three clips today, you know what I'm saying, that I really want to sink in, you know what I mean? And we're going to get back to Sheila Agee's ass. She's a murdering ass mom, you know what I mean? Murdering ass fucking son, husband, wifey is what we going to call it, you know what I mean? She helped murder that girl, and the girl didn't do anything, you know what I mean? What the girl did was dated your son, husband, and you couldn't handle that shit. But more importantly, we're going to get to the first clip. And I have to revisit this clip because it's so important. I mean, this clip is important. Let me see. Let me cue it up. Yeah, let me cue this motherfucker up. Because it's important. I mean, this is real shit right here. It's fair use. Again, yeah, one of the most important clips that you will have ever see. Listen to what this lady says. This lady, she had interviewed Cam Newton. So I had to look her up more and see about her. This is her. This is a clip. Fair use, educational purposes on the LaQuinn Dickey Show. Here it is.
Were grooming their sons and raising their sons independently in the home before another male party was introduced. Mm. And a lot of times we don't talk about how women date their sons. Mm. And single mothers oftentimes do everything but fuck their sons. Mm. And they have that emotional stability that is built within the home. And that's the reason why I say, you know, a single mother is a fuckboy factory. And the reason why I say that is because it's not that a fuckboy can't be birthed from a two-parent home, although it is, you know, it's an abnormality, you know, it's an anomaly of sorts that you would encounter a significant amount of subpar men that have been raised in destructive two-parent homes. But single women become so emotionally dependent upon their children, specifically their sons, that they will convince themselves that they don't need a man until they encounter the space from being alone to genuinely being lonely. And now we're having to deal with the imbalance that was set in the household because this boy is not your son. He is your man. When you want to cuddle, you go lay down with them. When you want some emotional time, you go watch movies with them. You touch them and you rub them and you massage them. And you do these things, everything that you would do to a man to suffice that. A lot of women even dress their sons like the man that broke their heart.
This is tough. Well,
look at that, brother.
You are 100% what, right.
So I think that's the dichotomy. Like, I'm not saying that your children shouldn't have weight in your relationship. Right. But what I am saying that we have to look at it from an integral space. Like, why do they feel this way? Especially if you're dealing with a man child who is uncomfortable with your new partner. And this man child is not necessarily a little boy anymore. Like me, I have an adult son. I have a 21-year-old son. That we don't take it.
Let me stop that right there. So I had to replay that clip. You know what I'm saying? What was it, 2 weeks ago when I heard that or stumbled across that? Everything that she says right there is right on point. She's a counselor, I think, doctor, something like that, but she kills it, man. I mean, she killed that shit. I'm gonna show you a clip that I've seen too, And this is just a mini one. This is just something mini, because we got to get to Sheila AG and shit. You know what I mean? We got to get to the leader of the fucking son, husband, wifeys. You know what I mean? She's the boss at the end of the motherfucking round, or at the end of the game. That's the one you got to fight. And she's got the red lightsaber on the damn thumbnail. You know what I mean? This shit right here is not cool. Let me play this motherfucker real quick. Yeah, this one's not cool. Mm-mm-mm. Queued up. My ass up out of there. And this is it right here. Look at this shit right here. Look at this. Listen to this.
Between a mom and her boy is unbreakable.
No, nobody said don't love your kid now.
The love between a mom and her boy.
Nobody said
it's unbreakable.
This shit here. Look at them all
the
up on the back.
Between a mom.
Let me pause that motherfucker. All up on the back of her like that. Too big for that shit. For real. I would never come behind my mom like that. There ain't no motherfucking way. No way. No fucking way. Let me get into the thick of it. I mean, let me get into the thick of it, because I think I got a couple. Bear with me real quick on it. Yep, I think we got a couple motherfuckers that want to get on the show. Let's see what they say. Let's see. Let's get into the thick of it, though. Before that, before I invite anybody on here, let's get to the boss.
The mother charged in last Friday's deadly workplace shooting in Pensacola made her first court appearance this afternoon. 50-year-old Sheila Agee is now in the Escambia County, Florida jail, charged with principal
first-degree
murder. Today, a judge ordered that she remain in jail without bond, as her attorney argued the text messages between her and her son were taken out of context. Tanner Stewart with our sister station in Pensacola has the story.
At this time, the bond will remain at no bond. You'll be ordered to have no contact with any witnesses.
Sheila Agee, the mother of shooting suspect Keith Agee, making her first appearance before a judge in Escambia County, facing principal to murder charges. The arrest report released this week states Agee played a major role in the killing of Brooklyn Sims through her text conversation with her son. Much of the report details those text messages between the two provided by the sheriff's office. She's accused of providing her son with an alternative plan for the murder different than his plan to shoot Sims in the parking lot, providing the exact location of where Brooklyn Sims could be found, and also advising him not to tell his nanny because she'll try and talk him out of it. The report shows the text begin just hours before the shooting, around 10:30 in the morning, and go until almost 1 in the afternoon. It adds Sheila Agee failed to alert authorities of the plan despite Keith Agee traveling over an hour and a half to Pensacola from Calvert, Alabama, plus another 40 minutes following their last communication. Her lawyer in court on Thursday insisting the texts were misconstrued.
She is a principal to the alleged incident. The majority of the evidence that the court has reviewed is text messages that were taken out of context. And, Your Honor, to my knowledge, she has little or no prior criminal history that would support such a charge.
As WEAR has reported, we know the
son, husband, wifey is what she is.
Came from Sheila Agee. That reads, okay, then, stop texting me. I'm working. Do whatever. It was shortly after this, according to a witness account in the report, the shooter walked up to the victim, said a few words, and fired approximately 8 shots before running out of the store. Tanner Stewart, NBC 15 News.
We are also learning Keith Agee was found in a parking lot near a Mellow Mushroom in Pensacola, shirtless, with his hands in the air when authorities made the arrest. Shortly after, a loaded handgun was found along Davis Highway, the same street where the shooting occurred.
Trip, ain't it? So the mom tells him, basically, do whatever. When really she should have been like, nah, man, you're not doing that dumb shit. Get your head out your ass. All of that. Like I said in the beginning, or like the intro said, that frontal cortex was just not motherfucking working. And she wanted that girl really out of the picture, is what I can see on it. It's crazy. So we got another lady here going off and calls her man, well, not see, I done it again. Calls her son her man and shit. Because she's so fucking confused because that front damn cortex and shit from the frontal lobe that gives you rationale in the brain, motherfucker can't have it. Not at all. Let me type this in real quick. Let's see. Mom calls her son her man. Here's a clip. There it is. Let me cue that motherfucker up. This is real shit going on. This son husband shit is real. Check it out.
The camera, I got my own too. All right, whatever.
You little racist ass, bro.
You a hater? You broke out of fucking strip club.
She wasn't no fucking stripper. She wasn't
move,
no stripper.
Move.
She pissed.
I'm not gonna touch you.
Wait in the car. Wait.
I'm not, bro. Our stuff is here. I'm not, though. My stuff is here and I'm getting my stuff.
Get your ass in that motherfucking car.
But I'm not, though.
Whoa.
Get your ass away.
But I'm not, though.
Can you go in your room?
Matter of fact, I'll call home right now.
Please don't, because my stuff is here.
We leave. You ain't got to do all that. You don't.
What did I do to you? What did I do to you?
I don't like you.
What did I do to you? What did I do?
You're a dirty asshole. And you're
shit
for my man, my son.
There it go. See, I'm guilty of that tonight. I did it, what, 3 times? Because these motherfuckers really got me convinced that that's really they man. You know what I'm saying? She said, my man.
My opinion on women raising men to be gentlemen is...
He ain't supposed to be in this motherfucker. I just slid my finger on that bitch on accident. But back to the lady calling her a man. Right? It slipped out. You know? So you can't tell me that these motherfuckers is not really tripping on that shit. You know what I mean? It's real. You know what I mean? I never knew the shit was happening. But in the beginning... As a little boy, I said, when the boy stole my bike and shit, and I went to go fucking confront him, give me my shit, his mom acting like that, you know what I'm saying? All fucking crazy, shouting and shit. The motherfucker's Jerry curl like that, all fucking just pristine as fuck. This shit's all making sense now. You know what I mean? It's all making fucking sense. And they even go in on... So this is the last clip right here because we 23 minutes in. This is the last fucking clip of the night. You know what I mean? I'm going to get into this and then I'm gonna bring somebody on here, man, to talk about it. You know what I mean? Somebody rational-minded, real rational-minded. But check this clip out real quick so you can see this and you tell me what you think. Check it out.
Now,
I let him know what's up.
He ain't going nowhere. That's my son. That's my only son.
At some point, he got to go.
Never no time.
I mean, at some point,
he never got to go. Never no time. Never no time.
Well, tell him, Christian.
You talking about you grown and you got to go somewhere. I told him, you only son, you ain't going no damn way. You go when you get ready.
Man, I just feel at some point you need to make your own way. That's what I, you know, I be going to walk through the house naked sometime, and there you go.
Okay.
You know? So, I mean, what, you know?
No, if anything, you can go, not him.
Oh.
How about I want to don't tell me where I can go.
But the thing is, like, why do I got to, this is my mama house, like, why do I got to leave my mama house?
Period.
Man, you damn near 40 years old, damn near it's time to go. I mean, at what point?
I'm 29, I'm not damn near 40.
Well, 29.
Pretty good. 10
but
years
you know
away,
what, when I met you, you was living with your mama.
Man, please,
you
I was in and
your,
out, come
you
on, man.
You was living with your mama,
I was only
22
years old.
Now you gonna tell me, because he's 29.
I ain't getting up.
Man,
I'm not going nowhere.
He said he ain't getting up.
You ain't got to go nowhere.
You know what, damn it, I ain't gonna pay no bills either then, damn it. Now, how you feel about that? You don't want him to go? I won't pay the bills. But
he's going to continue to pay the bills.
He got to go, though.
Continue to pay.
See, we arguing and stuff about stuff.
But at the end of the day, all y'all do is tell me to help. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Man, you a grown-ass man. You supposed to know the, oh, man, garbage overfill. You supposed to know to take that outside. Come on, man. I don't have to tell you all this stuff, man.
The thing is, I'm barely here, so I'm barely making garbage. So why I got to the garbage shop, I'm barely here. If I'm barely here, barely making garbage, barely making dishes, like, why I got to do anything?
Well, she gonna always make excuses for you, man. But
right, he don't even be here. So what is you talking about? He don't be here like that. He come here,
well,
he sleep, and
here,
then he on business the rest
out.
Of the day.
When he's here, he need to help out. He need to do some things. He
well,
need
I
to
tell
be
you
re-
what,
productive.
He ain't
okay.
paying no
well,
bills.
Well, damn
and
it,
he
gonna
ain't
start
gotta
paying
go.
Some bills around
I
this
ain't
house.
Paying, but I ain't paying.
He ain't wanna pay no bills either.
But listen, my mama said I gotta pay no bills. I ain't paying no bills.
He gotta pay. What I want him to do is save his money and do what he need to do with his money.
You see, you the whole reason why
he
is the way
he
is. Because all this soft shit that you bring into him, you still got the titty in the mouth. You let all that stuff go on.
Nah, you know what I know? You know, you jealous. You jealous of my...
See, I don't know if this is a skit.
Only you will say some bull crap.
I don't know if you just not, but I just know I ain't getting on my mama's house. Like, if I gotta get my mama's house, you gotta put me on my mama's house at the end of the day.
Well,
just
damn it, don't be carrying
your
out.
You know what I mean? You want to carry your profile then, if
ain't
that's
no
the
case. I know why I'm carrying them out. I just shoot them on out. And
Michael, now you know good and damn well. I'm not kicking my son out.
I ain't worried about it. Like, at the end of the day, I'm here. I live here, so until I'm ready to get out, I'm gonna be here. So,
at what point is you trying to? What's your plans for this man?
My plan is to stay in here as long as I need to stay in here. That's my.
I mean, what if he
45, 50?
And
he gonna be 45, 50 up in here.
Crazy.
What? Damn it! I'm gonna be out there.
He's going to get the stepping. Get the stepping. Because this my only son. He ain't going nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's
my going. Only son, shit.
You the one made him like this. Because your weak ass,
you know
you
what?
Made him.
Come and go, your son is forever.
That's wild. That's wild shit.
You
see what I'm saying? That's
right.
You made him this way. You made him
no,
this way.
Make him this way.
Look at that, son. That is called son. Yep, son, husband, wifey.
Know how to get out here. Like I said, when he ready to go, he can go.
Son, husband, wifey. But that's that. That's that clip. But like I said, I got two people on here, and I'm gonna go ahead and put in the show. Let me see if I could do some introductions like Shannon Sharp do. Okay, y'all both are on the conference. So number one, we got Armando in here. Y'all know he's my partner. So Armando's not on here just to fucking agree with me, anything like that. The reason why Armando's on here is because Armando, you know what I'm saying, he has a good view because of his mother. Okay. And then we got Miss Clayton on here. Okay. Miss Clayton is, she's just really level headed with everything. You know what I mean? We have a whole bunch of conversations. If I'm over there doing work at her place, shit like that. And I say, hey, you should come on the show. Matter of fact, you should be.
What's good, people?
You know what I'm saying? What the
Welcome
fuck?
Welcome back to hold the Onyx Report, Black Masking.
So, I'm telling her like she should be on a podcast. You know what I mean? What's up, y'all? Say what's up.
Hey.
Mondo.
Hey, good afternoon.
What's up, what's up, what's up, y'all? So, I sent y'all both two clips, right? And we're going to talk about the lady first, who called her son her man. And just give me your insight on it, Miss Clayton. I want to hear from you first. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
I want to hear from you first, and we just going to go ahead and go at it, okay? Because I want to save that last clip with the dude and the mom and all that shit. Let's save that motherfucker for last. So we 30 minutes in. Let's get this motherfucker like a good 10, 15 minutes.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, go ahead.
No, I mean, that situation as a whole is just wild. Yeah, mom's got to, he's got to fall back. And, you know, to call and refer to your son as your man, it could have been a slip up, who knows? But at the end of the day, I don't think I've got a 13-year-old son, and I've never referred to my son as my man.
Okay.
Those are, you know, two totally different lanes. Two totally different individual roles. And no, mom was out of pocket. She was out of pocket for all of it.
How do you think, and this is just a question, do you think she was really jealous of the girlfriend? Because how she was acting, running around the car, all of that.
You could say that from her actions, absolutely. But I don't know the context of that whole situation.
True.
But I know that's something I would never do. Absolutely not. And you know, that's just speaking to me. You know, thank God my son is only 13. We're not there yet. But I highly doubt in any situation like that. First off, my son wouldn't be in a situation like that, because I want to raise my son to be his own man and not live up under mama.
Okay. Okay.
First and foremost, because he's not going to be a burden to me. He's not going to be a burden to society. And I'm not raising him to be a burden to any other woman.
There it is.
Okay.
There it is.
So I don't see myself in that situation, but that lack of emotional control. And yeah, I mean, it's very possible she may be jealous of the girlfriend, not wanting to let go. That's her baby. That's her son. That's her man, as she put it. But no, just way out of pocket. The whole situation's out of control. And, you know, mom, son, as well as a girlfriend, there's just lack of responsibility, accountability. It's just lacking so many things that are necessary to carry on a mother and son relationship, son and girlfriend relationship. It just lacks. It lacks a lot of common sense.
Yep, and I think that they lacked a lot of respect for each other too.
Oh, absolutely. You know what
I
mean?
Because I could tell that the dude really wanted his girl. Mondo, chime in on that one, on that clip with the dude and his mom and shit, with her telling him that that's my man.
Oh yeah, no, she was definitely jealous. You could tell she was talking to the guy's girlfriend.
Okay.
Just how she was reacting with everything, him trying to leave the house.
Right, and as men, Mondo, do you think mama just needed some ding-a-ling? Well, the thing is, if she wasn't so concentrated on son, husband like that, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Maybe somebody would come through there and drop a motherfucking at a 60-degree angle down on her ass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know? And so,
yeah.
What do you think about, Mondo, how the girlfriend acted on that?
I think she would have she reacted the wrong way. If she wanted his son so bad, she just left him there. That's not a real man, shit. You know.
Right.
Like the Lord word says, you know, a man should leave his father and mother and unite with his wife and become one flesh.
Ooh.
He wasn't doing that.
Mondo preaching today on the Dickie Show. What?
You know.
Okay. Okay, so do you think that the girlfriend was like, okay, I'm sick of this bullshit? Because it could have been, you know, problem after problem. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man, that would have brought more problems after.
Yeah.
She could have saved a whole lot of problems with that.
Yeah, and I agree. Girlfriend should have walked away from the situation. Her belongings could have been retrieved by some other means down the road. But yeah, for respect for herself, she should have walked away from the situation instead of trying to compete with the mom. And I think she threw it out there in the face when he said something along the lines of his girlfriend comes before mom. That's not necessary.
Nah.
You lack respect for his mom, you lack respect for him, and you lack respect for yourself. Because I tell you what, I will not, under any circumstances, argue back and forth with a man that I'm with, husband, boyfriend, otherwise, I'm not going back and forth with his mama. I'm not competing with his mama. Again, everybody's got their lane and their roles to play. Mom is mom. I could never be his mother. Don't ever want to be his mother. Ain't trying to replace his mother. And, you know, the son is the son. And whatever goes on between son and said girlfriend is between son and said girlfriend. But she's got to stay in her lane. She's got to give respect to the mother, regardless of how she feels about it. You walk away. You leave. You have respect for yourself. You show respect to your elder and you leave that situation and you leave him there to deal with his mama.
Okay. There it is. Now,
if you got an issue with him and the way things are being handled between him and his mama, then you take that up later with him. But I've never been one for the girlfriend, the wife, whatever the situation is, going back and forth with a man's mother. Absolutely not. We don't do that.
Okay,
we
don't do that. You know y'all allowed to cuss on this motherfucker. Okay, this is Nikki's show. Y'all can cuss, but
I still gotta be a lady.
Okay, you're right, Mondo. You can say motherfucker too.
Be a lady. All right.
So, but check this one out. So the last video, and let me hit on that just a little bit first, because how the man was getting treated by his girl, right? And, you know, as black men in here, we're trying to really get brothers to do, younger brothers to do, you know what I mean? To achieve, right? So you have this brother, you know what I'm saying, being basically emasculated on the video, because the lady has the video and she's filming him, telling him basically, you're going to go ahead and pay bills anyway, right? And telling them, you know, my son's not going nowhere, this and that. And I really think that the brother was trying to say, hey, look, dude has to fucking get out there in the world and do, you know what I mean? Because we all know, we see it every day. Mondo, we're out there. Miss Clayton, you're out there as well. We know this shit is set up for different races, you know what I mean, another way. So you got the regular, you know what I mean, white dudes, you know what I mean, they might own businesses or whatever. You got Chinese people, they got businesses as well, right? Mexican dudes, they're coming up in the world, they got businesses as well too. You know what I mean? I got a guy who does landscape, motherfucker makes a killing, he's out there doing it, has both of his sons work with him, right? And it wasn't on no shit of, okay, you guys can go ahead and sit around, have fun, live with you know, me and mom this whole time. These dudes are young as shit and out there getting it. You know what I mean? They got nice trucks, the whole nine, right? You got the white dudes who got businesses. If their son does fall behind, they can always go ahead and take over that business, or they'll get given that business, right? Same with Chinese people that have a different grind. I see with us black folk, with this son husband shit, moms will hold the boy, and they under fucking perform. I just said a couple minutes ago, I do see a lot of these dudes I grew up with, right? Who I found out later on in life, like, shit, motherfucker was coddled. That's why he wasn't out there fighting and shit like us. Dude is knocking up dudes, are knocking up these girls to live with them, live off of them. You know what I'm saying? And they're underperforming in life. And we already got it hard enough. I don't think there's anything wrong with what that brother said in that video about this boy going out there and getting it himself. He was 29 years old and he wants to stay in mom's tit. And that's just not what it is. You know what I'm saying? It's not the way of the world. And I know a lot of people can say it's mean, it's the American way and shit, you know, get out when you're 18, this and that. It's not get out when you're 18 like that. It's start to prepare this kid with school, okay, with grind, all of that. Start to prepare them so they can get out there in the world and not be on mom's tit. You know what I'm saying? I really feel like mom was a son, husband, wifey, how she did him like that and how she tried to emasculate him on the video like that. Miss Clayton, you go ahead, go first.
Yeah, that was that was cold-blooded. And again, just like I said for the young lady in the other video, I'm going to say for the boyfriend or husband in this situation, man, grab your self-respect and your dignity and get up out of that situation. again, mom is being an enabler. She's enabling this young man to have bad habits. The example I'll use is he was saying that, you know, he wasn't taking out the trash or whatever he said in respect to that. But yeah, I don't care if you're laying up in there to sleep. I don't care if you're coming over to brush your teeth, wash your face. If the trash is full, take the shit out. I don't care, you know, to what extent or to, you know, what minimal role you think you played here. But at the end of the day, I think the problem lies in, if he is staying there for whatever reason, there were no rules in place. There were no boundaries set. And that first and foremost needs to be established. We need rules and boundaries for the son, whether he's grown or not, whether that's her son or not. We need some rules and boundaries, first off. Secondly, give this man that is there with you, that is living under your roof and paying bills under said roof, give him his respect and give him his credit for being a man.
See?
Taking care of his boy's mama, paying bills in his mama's house, because he could be easily like the son, saying he ain't paying no bills, he ain't taking out no trash, because he only X, Y, and Z. So we're enabling these bad habits, and we're not giving this particular man his dues when he's doing what a man is supposed to do. And yes, the son needs to get up out. You're 29 years old, or make your own way. I don't know what situation he endured that's got him at mom's house, that's got him not paying bills or, you know, doing what a man's supposed to do. But we've got to stop enabling those bad habits. We got to start raising our young boys to be men, to have their own, and to be able to take care of themselves. Mm-hmm. We got to stop the enabling of this bad habit. We got to stop enabling this laziness. And again, we've got to let sons know what their lanes are. You're not my husband. You're not my man. You're my child. You're my son. You stay in that lane. This man is my man. He can't do what a son does. You can't do what my man does. Those lanes don't cross. They don't intertwine. None of that. We've got to keep people in their respective lanes. And I think that'll take a lot of the confusion out. I think that'll take a lot of the disrespect out. Mm-hmm. And moms, we've got to stop coddling these boys. We've got to stop defending them at all costs. When they're wrong, they're wrong. When they need to grow up and be men, we've got to let them grow up and be men. Yes, we want to protect our sons. Yes, we want to be there to be on their team and support them. We can still give them all that. But in the same breath, we still have to allow them to be men.
Be men.
And that's what I'm going to say about that.
Yeah, and she had she's got a man in the house, right? And for her to say that, you're going to keep paying bills around here like that. Like, you sit here and see this man get up every day and go to work and shit. You going to do him like that and film him? Come on,
absolutely
man.
Absolutely not.
Come on.
Well, and then on. But yet you putting this man on blast.
Yeah.
But what about your son? You blocking out your face, son. Why? Because you know your son is going to be a burden to somebody else.
Yeah, he gonna go to somebody's crib and shit, feet smelling like motherfucking Frito-Lay factory and shit, playing video games. You know what I'm saying? He about to be off in that motherfucker.
She gotta cover his face up because she don't want these women out here to see who her son is.
Yeah, it is.
Because she already knows if women see that this particular man, 29 years old, at home with his mama, talking trash to the man of the house. The man of the house is paying the bills. The man of the house is taking care of and loving and supporting your mama, not only in the physical realm, but monetarily as well. She don't want nobody to see that.
Mondo.
What woman is going to accept that? What woman is going to be okay with that man?
Mm-hmm.
None that I know. None that I know.
Mondo, we see it every day on the job sites, all that, man. What's up?
Every day these...
But just I didn't mean to cut you off. Sorry, Mondo. But just tell, when did you start plumbing?
I started plumbing right after high school in 2012, after I graduated. Before that, I was washing cars, working, and I started working in Mexico when I was like 13, 14, buying my own cows and slaughtering them. I had a meat store running. You know? If I wasn't working, I would get in trouble and I wouldn't get no money and my dad wouldn't let me borrow the truck to go out.
Mm.
Now these kids nowadays, they're just cuddling them, playing video games. You know, and at a moment, on that video, the lady said that the man was jealous of her son, you know?
That's a shame. Shaming tactic.
Hardly.
Why would somebody that works, that's the man of the house, I bet you he's got money on his pocket all the mm-hmm. time. Why would he be jealous of somebody that doesn't work?
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't want to do nothing at home.
Right? Right? Go ahead, spit that shit. Spit that shit, Mondo.
No, those are the facts in that video. And we see it every day.
Every day, man. On the job site, there's no young people coming up in the workforce. Nope. You know what I mean? So you got to be... You got to be worried about infrastructure, period, here. There's nobody doing shit. It's so hard to find fucking help. It really is. And this is all fucking produced at home. Son, wifey, son, husband, wifey, you know what I'm saying? Doing that shit. You know what I mean?
Mom's not giving them any responsibility. She's not holding them accountable to anything. There's no push to achieve. There's no push to be resilient and have your own and take pride in having your own.
Nobody's proud. Proud nowadays.
No, not at all. Not at all. So we're essentially setting these young boys up for failure. We're setting them up for failure. And you know, I have a daughter too. She's 25. But I don't want my daughter with a man like any of these man. Fellas in these videos.
No.
Mondo,
I don't want my daughter to date.
Mondo, what you gonna say when your baby girl come to you and be like, "Hey, this is my man right here"? What's the first thing you gonna ask this little motherfucker when you meet him? What's the first thing you ask him?
No, if he work, what's he gonna do? What is planned for future?
There it is. Mm-hmm. That's why God said, Lamont, you don't get no motherfucking daughter. That's the reason why. Straight up. But nah, y'all. Shit, it's been great. We 47 minutes in the hole. This has been a first test of getting people on the show just to trying to just fuck with it a little bit. So I don't got no sponsor for the show. So Miss Clayton, why don't you just go ahead and shout out the dental office? Why don't that be the sponsor for the show? Fuck it. Go ahead.
Better yet, I'm gonna give them my real estate.
Fuck that. Yeah, do that. Do that shit. Yep. Go ahead. Real estate.
All right, y'all. Y'all need to buy or sell a home. I got you. LaShonda Clayton with Home Smart Realty. 720-270-5960. If you're in the Metro Denver area, I got you.
Got you. Mondo, you want to shout out?
Go ahead.
Go ahead. Shout out that tactical, baby.
You know, that junior tactical out here in Denver, for all the Hispanic community or anybody that wants to join and train, we are here for these rough moments right now.
Yes, it is. So, yes, it is. So the next show is going to be about the Venezuelan shit. This has been the conclusion of Reward Without Work and shit. This is Son, Husband, Wifey Strikes Back. Thank y'all for coming on here, man. That concludes the Dickie Show.
Thanks for having us.
Yes, anytime.
Thank you.
Anytime, y'all.
Y'all have a good night.
Y'all too.
All right, good night.
Peace. It was a pleasure.
Right on.
Bye.
That concludes tonight. We out.